Hey everyone, in this video we are going to see how we can visualize the communities in the Zikari Karate network. So I have this Gephi open already. I am going to open the new project, and in the overview I'm going to open the the file which is containing the karate network. So I already have this karate.gml file. I'm going to open that. I know that this is undirected, so I'm going to select that. This has 34 nodes and 78 edges. Okay, this is the graph that we are getting. I think we did it in the previous video as well. Let me zoom in. So this is the karate network. Let me thicken the edges. Okay, let me increase the node size maybe. So I'll go to nodes and I'll change the size of the nodes. Let me keep it 20. Okay, doesn't look so nice because they are black in color. So let me change the color of the nodes. Let me have something like this maybe. Oh, so it has changed the color of the edges as well. Let me change the color of the edges. Maybe this one. Let's see. Not so good. Maybe little darker. Okay, decent. Okay, so I have to show you how to visualize the communities in this network. So I'm going to go to this right hand side panel. Here we have this modularity feature. I'm going to run this. And here we have this resolution value. If the value is less, then we get more communities. This resolution value is higher, we get less communities. Let's see how many communities we get with this value of resolution. So okay, this is what we get. We get 4 communities here. All right, and these are the communities 0, 1, 2, and 3. These are, you see the small red dots, these are the a number of nodes in these communities. Okay, I'm going to close it. It's well known that Zikari Karate network had 2 communities. So I'm going to change the value of this resolution so that we get 2 communities. Let's change this value to 2 and let's see how many communities do we get. Okay, we are getting 2 communities here, the 2 most prominent communities that existed at the time of some kind of fight that happened there. You might be knowing the history behind this network. Okay, let's close this and let's try to visualize the communities. So I'm going to nodes, and we basically want to partition the nodes into 2 communities. So communities have already been found, we just want to display them accordingly. So we want to change the color of the nodes based on the partitioning that has happened because of communities. So nodes is selected, colors is selected, partition we will click, and here we have this modularity class. You see there are 2 communities, so we are getting 2 different colors here. When I apply, okay, so you see the nodes have changed color based on the communities that they belong to. So this is nice. We can see the nodes which belong to different communities. And in case you want to display the labels so that you get to know which node belongs to which community, you can do that. So I'm going to click this. So you see the labels of the nodes is also visible. Let me show you some layouts that might be useful maybe in this situation. Okay, let me show you this force atlas layout. So what this layout does is it forces the nodes in a given community to be displayed together, right? So let's run this. It's not looking so nice. I'm going to stop it. So I'm going to increase this value of repulsion strength. So as of now the nodes have gotten clustered together based on the communities. You see all the green nodes are on one side and all the pink nodes are on the other side, but it's difficult to see them because the repulsion is less. So let me increase the value of repulsion maybe to this value. You can just do hit and try. Yeah, so this is a little better. So I'm going to stop it. So green nodes are on the left hand side and pink nodes are on the right hand side. So this is a little better visualization. Let me increase the size of nodes so that the labels are visible better. So I'm going to nodes, unique and color. Okay, partitioning we have done. Okay, size, basically we have to change size. So let me make it 30, a little better. Yeah, so this is one thing. Another thing that we can do here is that we can change the size of the nodes based on degree. So I'm in nodes, I'll change the size. Basically I'm going to rank the nodes based on degree. So I'm going to click on ranking and the attribute that I'll choose will be degree. So I think this is good enough. 100 should be the maximum size. Okay, so this is what I see, right? So so you can quickly see which are the nodes that are having the higher degree, and you can obviously see the communities that they belong to. Let me also show you one more layout here, which is Force Atlas 2. There's one particular nice feature that I like about it, and let me show you that. Okay, let me click prevent overlap because I see some of the nodes overlapping, so I don't want that to happen. I think yes, we can go ahead. So you see what it is doing. It's sort of moving the graph. So wherever you like it, you can just stop. Maybe I like the green nodes to be in this direction, I'll stop it. So that is one thing. And since the repulsion has reduced, so I can go back to this force atlas and then run it, and then again I get the nodes far apart from each other, so that I can nicely see them. So when you see the kind of highlighting that is happening when you hover your mouse on one node, all the nodes in that community are visible, and so on. Let me reduce the size so that I can this is the labeling. Okay, let me go back here. So this is the network that you can see, and you can also go to data laboratory. Okay, so here you see modularity class for every node is given. You can just export this table so that you can use it the way you want in any other tool as well. So there are two modularity classes, 0 and 1, because there are two communities here. And you can also go to preview, and let me press refresh. That was about how we can visualize communities in Gephi. So that was a brief introduction to a few features of Gephi with respect to visualizing the communities in the graph.